Welcome back. It's Friday, so you're probably looking forward to the weekend. But what if it already were the weekend? Senator Bernie Sanders is now leading the latest push for a standard four-day work week without losing any pay. The Vermont senator introduced a bill on Capitol Hill yesterday called the 32-Hour Work Week Act. It would reduce the work week from, you guessed it, 40 hours to 32 hours over the span of 4 years. It would protect workers' pay and benefits.
There are companies all over our country and all over the world that have adopted the 40-hour work week. You know what they found? They found that productivity actually went up because workers were able to focus on their work. They were not exhausted. They were happy to go to work.
For more on this, we are joined by Chief Scientist of Workplace Culture at Culture Partners, Dr. Jessica Kriegel. Good to have you with us. So let's walk through pros and cons of a four-day work week, because as you pointed out to us, there are some cons, right?
Yes, absolutely. So from an employee perspective, it's everything that you could dream of. You're less stressed out. You're less burned out. You're happier in your job. And for those companies that were in the pilot, they also got great results. Their revenue increased. Their turnover went down. It looks like a dream. However, and this is really important, those are all companies that opted into this because they already had leadership aligned around a culture that would support that kind of initiative. I don't know that that's going to be the same experience if this is a mandate that reluctant companies have to enact within their own organizations. I think that the con, if it's a mandate, is that stress might actually go up. Results could go down because the leadership team would not be aligned around the cultural belief that this is a good thing for the company. So it could be bad news if they're not coming to it organically like those in the pilot.
Yeah, especially if you have a huge workload and fewer hours to get the work done. So we do have evidence that we can look at, as Senator Sanders mentioned. We've already seen some companies and countries adopt the four-day work week. What are some of the results we've seen from this model?
From a revenue perspective, we saw 34.5% increase in revenue for those that opted into the pilot. We also saw 92% of the companies that were in the pilot deciding to continue with the four-day work week after the pilot was over. So clearly it was working for them. And it does work when it has come to organically. There are a lot of organizations in America, as he said, that have already adopted a four-day work week. You see it more for office workers than you do for manufacturing. There are some exceptions. Great Dane Trailer has a four-day work week. They are getting results. It's working. But Great Dane Trailers cares deeply about their workforce and the happiness of their workforce. That's a competitive advantage for them right now because there are thousands of other manufacturing companies that would not do that unless they were forced to. So it's all about the leadership mindset and the shared cultural belief that we want to have about the nature of our relationship with work.
So one of the reasons we're even talking about this is stress. I mean, just how stressed out is the American worker right now?
I think we're at an all-time high of stress. American workers are at their wit's end, and you're seeing that in the levels of depression, the levels of anxiety, even the levels of suicide. Financial stressors are at the top of the list, and I just recently saw research on the breakdown of the most stressed out jobs. This spans all walks of life. Steel workers at the top of the list for the most stressful job, but right after that is surgeons and lawyers. So this isn't about whether you're a frontline worker or an office worker. Everyone is feeling the pain. And I applaud this initiative to have us ask that sort of existential question about, are we putting too much into the work aspect of our lives and do we need more balance? I think that's an important question. And I hope that the leaders across America will think thoughtfully about it.
Some are worried this change could cause even more stress. I want to play some sound from yesterday's hearing here.
And if you want to see those same employees really stressed out, just see what happens where their employers lay them off to hire part-time workers instead or have to close their doors because they cannot make enough revenue.
Dr. Kriegel, we're tight on time here, but real quick, your thoughts on that argument.
Absolutely. The stress can also come in the form of freaked out managers that are forcing more productivity into those 32 hours, even if they're not laid off, which is why we have to be careful about implementing this unless it makes sense for your business.
All right. Interesting conversation. Dr. Jessica Kriegel, thanks for bringing us some information to help us have an educated discussion about all this.